It's business as usual on a Friday afternoon at the Philippine Commission on Human Rights. An officer of the day receives complaints. Investigators probe human rights violations, including the recent case of two missing labor activists. And the commission launches a partnership with a school and an NGO to show videos that promote human rights.
Kalahati po ng taon, 55,000 na po ang aming na-train. Kasama na po dyan ang mga teachers, mga guro, sa pagtuturo po nila sa human rights. At sa publiko na rin po, nagkaroon po kami ng mahigit na 23,000, halos 23,000 po na participants buhat sa military at sa police.
This despite having no chairperson and commissioners for months now. The 7-year term for the chair and 4 commissioners all lapsed on May 7. Nobody has been appointed to take their place, not even a whisper of who are in the running. Executive Director Jacqueline Ann Diguia, who serves as the commission's caretaker, says they continue to soldier on despite some limitations.
So basically, operations-wise, patuloy yung trabaho ng CHR. Ang hampered, of course, doon sa continued absence of the appointment of a chairperson and commissioners ay yung aming hiring and recruitment ng investigators and lawyers in the regions who carry out the very important work in terms of operations.
Of the 864 positions at the CHR, more than 200 are vacant and could still not be filled with the absence of the appointing authority. The commission or any of its units could not enter into agreements with partners who have been instrumental in keeping the commission's activities alive despite the meager budget.
Meron kaming program yung partnership with educational institution, since one of the requirements is to have a memorandum of agreement by which yung commissioner sana yung pipirma. Right now, hindi kami makapag-establish ng ganun.
Albay Representative Ed Seligman warns the Philippine CHR risks losing its Status A accreditation at the Global Alliance of National Human Rights Institutions if the prescribed criteria of choosing commissioners are not followed. That criteria must be transparent, and the commissioners must be independent, coming from diverse backgrounds. The CHR also needs to have its own charter and must have fiscal autonomy. The commission is facing a budget slash for next year's budget. But what is the prospect of appointing credible and independent CHR commissioners under a Marcos presidency? The CHR was created under the Constitution in response to the numerous human rights violations under martial law during the term of former dictator Ferdinand Marcos Sr.
We have gone upon the new administration to appoint veritable human rights advocates who would be steadfast in their advocacy for the promotion and protection of human rights.
The president did say that he commits to human rights protection and promotion when he met with the United Nations resident coordinator, and we are hopeful that he will follow through with his commitment.
For a former CHR commissioner, it would help if one of the commissioners would at least come from within.
So ang wish ko, sana may tagaloob.
Okay.
Kasi lang nila nung alam nila yung internal like dynamics also ng commission. Mm-hmm. So in resource sila as a part of leading the commission. Mm-hmm. as a national human rights institution.
Balacanang has said the appointment is already under consideration and could come out any day now. Mike Navallo, ABS-CBN News.